Good morning to one and all present here. I can't hear you, friends. I said good morning. Myself, Ekta Sharma, I'm highly honored to welcome all our honorable dignitaries, our mentors, and all the summer interns to the final presentation of IIT Bombay Eklavya Summer Internship 2015. IIT Bombay, the known institute of our world, gives an opportunity to all the students of the different states and the different institute to work together as a summer intern under the mentorship of different faculty members and of course with the guidance of Professor D.B. Pathak sir. So friends, give a huge round of applause for yourself being deserving enough to be a part of IIT Bombay X. Now, I request Professor D.B. Pathak sir to motivate all our interns with your precious words. So friends, give a huge round of applause for Professor D.B. Pathak sir.
I'll not spend too much time here. Welcome to the final presentations. I have a lot of things to say, but I'll say them towards the end, the valedictory address, which will probably be during the dinner time. This is one opportunity where all of you get to see what other groups are doing. And that is the reason why I was not very happy when I did not see all the students here. I still do not see all 85 students. Please understand that what you have been doing very methodically over the last 2 months is something that goes back with you definitely. But what others are doing, you will never ever come to know. And you have spent 2 months with them here. So this is an occasion. Absorb whatever they have done. See how it fits into the larger scheme of things. And as far as this summer internship is concerned, I'm being wrongly given the credit. The entire summer internship, including those held in the past, have been organized entirely by Professor Avinash Aute and his team. So let us give him and his team a big hand. In order to not upset the schedule, what we have decided is we'll follow the schedule, but we are taking the starting point as 10 a.m., which is exactly 10 a.m. now. So Aparna's team to start off the presentation, and we'll try to stick to the schedule. The missed things between 9 to 10, Professor Aute will decide at what point in time they will be accommodated. Unfortunately, my life still continues to be out of control. I have 3 important meetings in between. So please excuse me if you find me going out suddenly and coming in suddenly, a privilege which is not available for others, by the way.
So now I'll be inviting IIT Bombay X Monitoring Application Group under the guidance of Aparna ma'am. So please, friends, give a huge round of applause for them.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Dilip Kumar. First of all, I would like to congratulate all of you on the successful completion of our internship. And I would like to thank Professor D.B. Pathak sir for providing all of us such a great opportunity to work at IIT Bombay. And I would like to thank Avate sir, who is continuously supervising our team. And I would like to thank our guide Aparna ma'am, who is there with us late nights also. So as today's part, let's discuss our project IIT Bombay X Map. This is introduction, I will discuss. So these are the contents that we are going to discuss in our presentation. WH words, like not all WHs, some of the questions, so where we can answer. Next one is architecture diagram. So how we developed our application, that going to be discussed in architecture diagram. Subsystems. So coming to IIT Bombay X, there are majorly 5 subsystems which we categorized it. The things we will discuss with a demo. And achievements, like throughout the internship, what we have achieved, technical, non-technical, those things we are going to discuss. And the next one, challenges and learnings, those also under internship, what we have got. And future roadmaps, we didn't implement all the things, so something is remained to continue the project. So those things we are discussing, and then conclusion. Next slide. First question, what is exactly IIT Bombay X map is? So as you see the name, it is a application. If you see, there is IIT Bombay X. So what this is a web-based application which takes the data from IIT Bombay X to generate such kind of reports of various roles. Roles means In learning system, there are various roles like faculty, student, and there are some other roles also, which you will see throughout the presentation. So how the various kind of reports are being generated for those roles, is those reports are under IIT Bombay XMAP. And why do we need it? So answer to this question is MOOCs are a little bit new to India. So people want to measure how effective MOOCs are there, means how they are effective in India. So that's why, in order to make it more effectively, we should give some reports to improve the performance. That's why we need this. And how IIT Bombay XMAP works and who will use it, these questions will carry out throughout the presentation. Coming to that question, how IIT Bombay XMAP works, that will be explained with architecture diagram by Kumar.
I would like to tell you how IIT Bombay XMAP will work. So this is the architecture diagram, and so comment service. In this comment service database, actually it is a part of OpenADX database in our IIT Bombay XMU. So this CS underscore comments means it contains discussion related details and courses. In this Mongo databases, we will be having all the courses stored in this database. LMS is this related to the student details and all. So this is our IIT Bombay X map system. It is related to our IIT Bombay X in this way. So we are using the databases that are owned by the IIT Bombay X, and these are the five subsystems included in our new application. FRS, faculty report system, admin report system, student report system, and general information report system, program manager report system. So throughout our project, we are using Django in our system. So now I would like to tell you the architecture of Django, how it works, and how it is connected with the databases and all. So this is the Django architecture. So initially, we will be using our systems or mobile devices, whatever, to request the to access this website. So we initially send the URL request. So it will come to the application, that logger application that is present in our new application. So this logger application will test the username and password, and then it will redirect to the different URLs present there. So these things will be there in the views. Views contain some APIs. So those APIs will fetch the data from these databases, and the fetched data will be again from API to views. These views will again take the templates from the Django, and these templates as well as the data will be rendered to the web browser present in our laptops or systems. So it is the Django server, and the response will be sent. Response will be sent as soon as the rendered to the web page. These high charts will be drawn. High charts will be drawn, and it has different parts like these five components, and each one will have paginated list display and page filter for effective navigation of users. So I would like to discuss some salient features in our system, like role-based access. So our system is completely built for user-specific role, based on the user view. So it has mainly five roles: faculty, student, program manager, admin, and general users. General users means public, who everybody can access this information. Summary and drill down for each type of report. So if you see some course details, if you click on that course, you can see students, and if you click on student, you will see the details of all the students. So we have implemented some drill down mechanism for the effective navigation, and filtering, search, and download of data is also available in our system, which is less implemented in the ADX, OpenADX. When number of users are more, we can't download the data or we can't view the data in ADX, and that is now possible with our system. And actionable presentation of data means if faculty sees some discussions, that unanswered questions, you can directly click on the link, as well, he can directly go to the IIT Bombay X map, IIT Bombay X, and he can view and answer the questions. So core structure will be explained by Devesh. Thank
you. Good morning, everyone. My name is Devesh Kumar. I am from Guru Nanak Dev University, Amritsar, and I am here to discuss about this course structure. Every course in IIT Bombay Axe has been divided into various parts, like sections, subsections, unit, and under unit, these all are the parts. For example, let us take one example. It will be better for us. For example, a course like CS101, which is developed by IIT Bombay, section may be a week wise, month wise. It develop. It depends on the course developer actually. It can be week wise, month wise, or day wise. Whatever course creator wants it. And under that, let us consider that subsection. Subsection may be like addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Let us consider these four subsections. And under these subsections, units. Units means under addition, let us consider two units, like addition of two numbers. It may be a video and text about that addition of two videos. And another unit may be addition of three numbers, like videos and all those things. This is the unit. And under unit, it contains HTML, video, discussion, and problem. Discussion will be for each unit, actually. And this, let us come to this HTML file. This is anonymous user ID. Under anonymous user ID, any that course creator or anyone can put that text, and it may relate that text to some link, which will be opened after clicking that. It is anonymous user ID. Zooming image. Zooming image here is, for example, when we see some image, all the parts may not be visible. So on clicking to some part of that image, it will be zoomed up. This is zooming image. And raw HTML. Raw HTML is actually just like text it is. But the difference between text and raw HTML is that raw HTML opens in raw HTML editor, while text generally opens in VI editors. And raw HTML is written as will be presented as you write that. Like if you will provide five spaces and all that things, in one line you write anything, it will be presented like that only. Announcement. These are those type of HTML text which needs to be seen by most of the people. And iframe are those things like tools which should be integrated or which need to be integrated with our system. And text, you know, everywhere. Then let's come to discussion. Discussion, it has two parts, general and cohort. A general discussion are those discussions which can be seen by anybody which has been put it on that course or in this unit. And cohorted is that, actually, this is a private group which can be seen by those person only which are connected to this cohort. Now come to problem. There are two parts, advanced and basic. Basic parts, we are using only basic parts right now. And under that problems, here it is blank common problem, check boxes, multiple choice, numerical input, text input, and drop down. And under advanced, it is like molecular structure related to chemistry and math expression, like advanced mathematics, blank advanced problem, circuit problem like electronics and electrical, and custom JavaScript and all those things. Next. Now, Nitesh will explain the faculty report.
Good morning, all. My name is Nitesh Deo, and I will be explaining you the faculty reports that we have implemented in our IIT Bombay X map application. Now, IIT Bombay X identifies a faculty as a person who creates and maintains courses. And we aim at providing him with informative reports so that he can enhance his course, and thus we can enhance the learning experience for the students of IIT Bombay X. Now let us sign in from the faculty account. Now, as you can see here, for the faculty we are showing four main types of reports: the course enrollment report, discussion forum activity report, the grading report, and the course-wise group reports. Now I will explain each of these reports one by one. Now let's talk about course enrollment report. Now all of these reports, the summary of all of these reports is shown on the dashboard page. Now for the course enrollment report, What we are showing on the dashboard page are the number of students per courses created by the faculty, as you can see here. Now, we can also click on any of this bar. It will redirect us to the total list of all the students for that course created by the faculty. As you can see here, we are getting a list of all the students under that particular course of the faculty. And there is also one special column, information column, on clicking on which the faculty can view the attendance report and the grading report for any particular students. Why we have included that is to help the faculty to monitor a student on an individual level. Now let's talk about the second type of reports. Now, as you all know, we all take MOOCs, and one of the most important factor that means that affects the MOOCs is the discussion forum activity. Means why we have included this type of report. Why we have included this type of report is that the faculty can view the discussion forum activity for his various courses, so that he can get various types of information, like which type of courses are most popular, which type of courses are facing most number of problems. Let's see the legend for this discussion forum activity dashboard report. Okay, so as you can see here, we are representing the information in the form of stacked bar chart and in the three sections. Now, in IIT Bombay X, each comment thread can be a discussion or a question. Now, and each question can be either answered or unanswered. And what we are showing here is the unanswered question, answered question, and the discussions. Now, each of these stack bar are clickable. When we click on any of this section, say suppose unanswered questions, we are redirected to the actual list of the all the unanswered questions. Now, what we have done here is we have given a provision of answering the question directly from here to the faculty. He can click on this link, answer the question for this question, and he will be redirected to this login page. Now, one of the things that we wanted to implement for IIT Bombay X map was the single sign-on. Means if single sign-on would have been implemented, then he would not have seen the login page for IIT Bombay X. That is a single sign-on between IIT Bombay X and IIT Bombay X map, these two projects. So he can sign in from his IIT Bombay X authentication, and he will directly see the question that he clicked on. Now he can directly post some response in here, and that will be reflected on the reports that we saw on the dashboard. As you can see here, we submitted the response, and the direct effect is shown on the discussion report that we are seeing here. Now, as you can see, first the number of answered question, the one in the green one, was showing only one answered question. Now it is showing two. And the question is also listed here. See, that the answer, the question is now answered. Now, this is one part. Now, what we can also achieve from this is the faculty can also validate the answer to the question. Means if the question is correctly answered or not, then he can comment on that. Also, he can click on the various discussions, and he will be redirected to the actual discussion on the IIT Bombay X, and he can then comment on any of the discussions and so on. So that's why we included this type of report. Now, coming to the third type of report, the most important report, the grading report. Now, what we have done here is, on the dashboard page, the faculty can see how his courses are performing on the basis of grading. Now, what we are showing here, as you can see in the legend there, are the course average and the maximum marks for a particular course. Now, here he can directly see the healthy comparison between his various courses, which course is doing well and so not, means on the basis of the average marks per course that is shown in this report. Now, each of these report is clickable. When we click on any of this bar, we are directed to the list of marks of all the students here. Now we have also implemented one functionality here by the means of which he can directly download all this information in the Excel format by clicking on this export. Here, as you can see, it will be downloaded and in the Excel format on his system. So by then he can use this report anywhere else. Then the Another type of reports that we are showing here is the are the course wise group reports. Now, as explained by Kumar, the means the faculty can also create groups amongst the in the courses he has created. Now we are also showing group wise course reports in here. On the dashboard page, what we are showing are the number of groups per course. Now here you can see he has created three groups in his one course. This one. Now he can directly click on it and he will get the detailed group report for that course, that group. Okay. Now he has created three groups. So what we are showing in the detailed group discussion, detailed group report is the first one is discussion activity report. Now this is the same report that I explained you earlier about the discussion activity report. You can directly answer the question from here. We validate the answered question by clicking on any of these bar graphs. Now another type of report that we are showing in the detailed group report is the group-wise student strength. Means he can see how many students are under what groups, and also he can get the total length of means total list of all the students that are under a particular group. Now if he clicks on any of this bar here corresponding to any group, he will get the list of all the courses, all the students, sorry, for that group. And he can we have also implemented a export facility here just like earlier, so he can download all the information. So this is it about the faculty panel. Now let's move on to the most important role for the any MOOC course, the student, and the student the student reports will be explained by Devesh.
Good morning again. Student report. In student report, we are explaining these things like attendance, details, summary. For every point, there will be some graph and pie charts or bar charts. Everything like grades obtained by that student, a course structure and attendance details, discussion forum activity, everything. And okay, coming to this, after entering the after entering the credentials of the student, it leads to student layout page. This student layout has been divided into two parts. Actually, this is dashboard and course structure. Clicking on dashboard, it leads to this course wise attendance, and these are all the number of courses which has been enrolled by that student through which we logged in. These are the visited sections and total number of total sections. Visited sections are those components of the course which has been visited by the student, like videos and HTML and problems like thing. Total sections are those sections which had been inputted by the course creator into this very course. For example, in CS301, 8 components has been visited out of total 13 components. Out of these, this total 13 components, we can see all these courses which had been enrolled by the student. Now we have an export button which leads to that XLS file, and we can get these all data in XLS format, and it leads to this data which can be used for further purposes like storing or using every another things. This is course wise grade. In course wise grade, we are defining all the these are the all courses which has been enrolled by that student, and for every course we are defining that grade maximum and that average thing. Like student grade means percentage of percentage marks which has been obtained by that student. For example, average is there 75 point something. Like student grade is 90.00, average is 75.83, and out of total means maximum percentage is 100%. After clicking on this, it leads to this quiz-wise performance of that student. Quiz-wise performance means each quiz of that very course on which we clicked there. It also shows the same thing, maximum, average, and marks obtained. Like maximum is 100%, average is 91.7, and marks obtained is 100% here. Marks obtained is 100% here. Coming to this course structure, these are all the courses which is enrolled by that student. For example, in MA101, these are all the subsections which are present, like addition, introduction, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Attended part and all those things, attended and unattended, we have divided this thing into two parts. For example, this is unattended one by one, means one subsection is unattended out of one total subsection present there. This is the need of this, and that attended part, attended 2 by 2. Attended 2 by 2 means two subsections has been attended out of that 2 section. On clicking to that unattended part, it leads to this. This is unattended 1 by 2 again, means one unit is unattended out of 2 units present inside that subsection. On clicking to this unit, it will lead to video and problem and everything what is present inside that. This is video unattended and numerical input which is attended inside that. So we can see the data hierarchy wise actually, like course, section, subsection, unit, and inside that whatever it is problem or anything else, what is present there. How do you determine what is visited? Actually, we are looking at in the MySQL database, it is whatever student sees, like video or problem, anything, it is stored in MySQL, and every data which is added by the course creator, it is stored in MongoDB. So from MongoDB, we are getting all those things, total number of components which is there, and total number of attended parts, it is from MySQL database.
Student course
there is actually, there are many attributes like ease, state, and all those things from that. Yeah, that's all. Thank you. And now Manisha will explain that.
MySQL database, which has information about the details attended, and what are the types of values it keeps? Is it only yes or no or something?
No, it is Boolean type of. There is a one table like course where student module, inside that you can get that data. It is actually a Boolean type. If it is attended type of thing, 0 and 1 type of thing.
And there is an entry for every student.
If any unit is attended on browser, then information about that particular unit, object ID of that particular unit, is stored in coursework student module. So from coursework student module, we are getting object IDs of that particular unit, and we are checked
it. So Nagesh, the event analytics people, I did not see this table mentioned by them. I have not seen that. There is a dichotomy. Good. Okay. Carry on.
Thank you, sir. This is admin report, and Manisha will explain this admin report.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Manisha. Now I'm going to explain you about the admin reports. What the admin can see from this IIT Bombay X MAP monitoring application. So basically, the admin can see all the reports related to number of registrations happened, the email sent course-wise, and the disk usage, what a particular course is occupying in the disk space. So here, the admin can monitor the health of the IIT Bombay X application. And when we log in as the admin, he'll be redirected to the admin dashboard, where he can see different kind of reports, such as number of emails sent course-wise, which specifies the number of emails sent for different courses. Then we have the number of registrations happened. That is, it gives the counts of the number of registrations happened on a particular day. Then the other kind of report, what the admin can see, is the course enrollment detail. In the course enrollment detail, it specifies the number of number of students who have enrolled for different courses, which specifies how many students have been enrolling for different courses, which course is being very active, and all that. And then the other kind of report, what admin can see, is the disk usage about every course, like the disk space what a course is occupying. Then going to the number of registrations again, if we click on a particular day in this graph, then it will redirect to the next level of detail, that is, which will specify the number of details about the users who have registered on that particular day, which we have clicked on. We can also filter this data by using specifying the start date and the end date, which will give the details about the users who have registered on between those two specific dates. Here, as we have entered two dates, this displays the registration details between those two specific dates. Then the other kind of report, what the admin can see.
Where you show the report of the graphical representation of the attendance, not attendance, enrollment. You should be able to produce a cumulative report as well, isn't it? That means on day one, there were so many, day two, there were so many, day three, there were so many, etc., etc.
Sir, this is actually the only the number of about the registration. This is about the course enrollment.
Oh, that is only the registration on the
only the registration on the IIT Bombay.
So on the course enrollment, can you not produce a cumulative report, day-wise cumulative report?
It is there, sir.
Achha.
Next level. First, I'm explaining the registration. This is the next level detail about the course emails sent. This specifies the number of emails sent on different days, course-wise. This gives the number of, it specifies like what all activities are going on, because by looking at the number of emails sent, the admin will get to know whether the course is active or some activity is going on or not. Then the other kind of detail what the admin can see is the course enrollment details. Previously, we had seen the registration details. This is enrollment details. This specifies the number of enrollments for different courses on different days. By clicking on a particular day, it specifies the course-wise details and the student enrolled on that particular day for different courses. So here, it gives the number of enrollments for various courses on that particular day which we had clicked. And then this gives the credentials or the details about the students who have enrolled for different courses on that particular day. These are the details which an admin can see. Okay, thank you.
What I mean by cumulative data is that, see, this is where Professor Gaitonde actually prepared a report by laboriously looking at the details given every day. So today so many, tomorrow so many, day after tomorrow so many. The point is, when I go to day after tomorrow, the IIT Bombay X dashboard does not tell me what was the situation day for yesterday.
Sir, it shows the number of enrollments for the courses created by a particular faculty.
Correct. So,
not every day.
That's the problem. Whenever I
so you can choose a particular day and you can verify what are the.
But if I, that's okay. So typically it is actually not per day kind of thing. What is important for us to understand, what is the consolidated enrollment that happens and when does it pick up? That statistical sense shall tell you where it is important. It tells us that next year, A, how much in advance we must announce the course, and B, at what time a advertising intervention has to happen to tell the students to enroll early. Because typically everywhere in the world, people will enroll towards the last day. Now, in the last few days, how many people have enrolled is not known. So what you will do is, you will show me on any time I click, you will show me the data that time. But there is no history available and there is no trend available. This trend is also important from another point of view. When I size my hardware requirement to support so many students, you assume that if the enrollment is open for 1 month, there will be an average load per day of something, which is not true. The load happens towards the last few days. What is the nature of that load could be very critically required. So that is, but that is a small extension that can be done.
So we have implemented that trend thing in registration. We can also extend it to the course enrollment.
Exactly, same data then, right.
Now Gunjan will explain about the program manager reports.
If you are doing that, if you are doing the trend per day for a faculty, okay. It's not admin. Okay, for a faculty, you have to extend the trend even after the course starts. you have this visited thing, correct? Section visited, right? The section visited count happens every day, correct? So can you not show how many students, okay? First of all, how many students enrolled as on each day, that kind of a graph, and as they start visiting, can you not show that graph going down? Because normally the student, the dropout ratio. So that would be good.
The problem is that even now that he mentions this, if you look at the visited information, which is actually quite important for a teacher, that visited information will only show the total cumulative visits as on the date. So actually what we should do is, we should internally run such things every day and maintain the count as a overall period. So we know exactly how many visits happened on which day, etc. So I hope you all appreciate that if people are undergoing a course, see, the whole thing about MOOCs is about knowing the learning behavior of the students. And the learning behavior is actually displayed through such statistics. And that is very critical in deciding the pedagogical corrections that the teacher needs to make on the issue. But this is very good. That is only an extension. At least do write in your final report. If you are not able to implement this, do write in your final report that this is suggested, and write a few lines about how this could be done. Okay. So you might have to put in, for example, one more table of the trends, which is date-wise. And every day, a batch runs it and accumulates that data.
Good morning, everyone. I am here to explain the program manager panel. Now, what is a program manager? So basically, a program manager can be thought of as a person who can see all the details about the partner institutes with IIT Bombay X. For example,
Many people here who may not be aware of this model that is actually getting rolled out as we speak. The model of blended MOOCs is as follows. Some institutions which are autonomous decide to use in their teaching of a subject their own teaching and the teaching from MOOCs from IIT Bombay. Now this is a unique model. It has not been tried anywhere in the world except for individual institute to institute kind of. We are trying it with 50 institutions. Many of which are your own institution. These are autonomous institutions, so they decide that one of the courses from IIT Bombay will be used in this blended model. Or maybe some institute says two, some institute says three. The model works like this. For each subject, there are teachers who offer MOOCs from here, and there are teachers in these 50 institutions who teach that course locally. There could be one or more teachers there. Each institute may take one, two, three or more courses for such model. So what we have agreed is that each institution will appoint a program coordinator who will locally coordinate these blended MOOC operations for all the courses that are run in the blended MOOCs. That program coordinator is supposed to inform to IIT Bombay who are the individual teachers teaching those subjects and so on and so forth. And the most critical aspect of this blended MOOC is not just teaching by a combined method, because that requires pedagogical inputs. For the topics which are covered by MOOCs, for example, a teacher in VNIT will say that I will not give lectures on these topics, but we will instead use classroom as discussion session. This is called a flipped classroom approach, and this will be attempted now. More importantly, every student of VNIT studying that course will get the final grade for that course combining two factors. One, the marks scored in the local assessment, and two, the marks scored in the online assessment. This is the part which has never been attempted. The MOOCs marks will then get mainstreamed into our education system, because those marks will have to be earned by students to just pass the normal course on. Now, it is for this reason that we need to build up a back-end system. For example, if I am a VNIT teacher, I would like to know week by week how my students are doing in MOOCs, because those marks matter. And that is the purpose of these reports that are being made.
Okay, let's visit the program manager panel. So this is the first report. This gives number of students per institute. These are the partner institutes of IIT Bombay X, and this gives the number of student enrollments under those organizations. Now, this is significant because this gives us the difference. This gives a difference that which of the organization is having a nice participation rate and all. So this
I made
is
a mistake. The work that I described will actually be shown by Shweta's team later. But there are partner institutions. For example, let me again take the example of PNIT. Forget the blended MOOCs. But VNIT, some people may be offering a MOOCs on IIT Bombay Expert. IIT Kharagpur may be offering a MOOC. So those are these partner institutions. And they would like to know what is the statistics of students studying courses offered by those partner institutions. Am I right? We have one partner institution now, by the way. It's called TIS.
On clicking the bar, we have the detailed description about which are the courses and how and for that particular course in that organization, how what are the number of enrollments. So these are those details. Now next we move on to the next set of records. The next reports on the panel, we have the next set of reports. Those are the certificate summary per institute. That is, for the institute, how many courses which are running are verified and how many are honored. So by on clicking on this, we will have the detailed description about which of the course is honored and which is verified. So this is a detailed description about that institute specifically. Now let's move on to the next set of reports, which is a program manager can also view the staff summary. That is, who are the faculty members who have whose courses are running on that site. So here these are the records. First filter is about institute wise. That is, on institute wise, we can suppose we selected IIT Bombay X, and this will give all the name of all the faculties whose courses are currently running on those on IIT Bombay X platform. The next set of filtering is on the basis of the course. We will restrict it that for that course, what are the faculties which have their courses running under that organization. So this is about whole program manager panel. Now next is our general information reports, which will be presented by Nikita.
Good morning all. My name is Nikita Begani. I'm from NIT Silchar. So now I'm going to explain the general information reports. Here, general information reports are those which are open to all. Anybody who wants to see the trend or the who want to research the demographic activities going on in IIT Bombay X, he or she can view that. So for that, we need to click here, and then we land up to the dashboard. Here we are showing five kinds of reports. Sorry, the first one is level of education. The second one is age-wise. Third one is gender-wise. Fourth one is state-wise, and the fifth and the last one is subject-wise. The first is level of education. Here, IIT Bombay X has specified level of 10 sets of level of educations, including people who have not specified their level of education and others. So from this, we can know that which level of education while registering a student has supposed entered bachelor's degree. So his data has been entered here, and we can view that details. So next we have the age-wise. For this, we have defined five different groups. The first one is less than 15 years of age, then 15 to 25, then 26 to 40, 41 to 60, and greater than 60. From this pie chart, we can view that which age group is participating or registering more in online or in IIT Bombay X site. So the next one is gender-wise. The gender-wise also shows the male and female. The users didn't specify their gender, so all these details can be viewed from this pie chart. So we can see that the male, some percent of male are females are participating lesser than males. So we can view that from this bar chart. This is an overall description. So all this comes in single page. So we can we are not giving the details basically, but we are giving overall data. So next, we have the state-wise. In state-wise, we are showing which state is which states students are participating or registering in IIT Bombay X. Like here in Maharashtra, the students registering are more compared to other states. From this, we can view these details. The next, we have the subject-wise. So for that, we need to go to the left panel and click on subject-wise, and we land up on this page. This page contains this. Courses are been divided in terms of subjects. So for that, we can view that how many students are enrolled in which subjects. Like here, we have computer science and computational maths. So we can view from this. So when we click on that select a subject, suppose, so we have maths. There is one course, but no student has been enrolled in that course. So that's why the graph is not showing that course. So this is all about general information reports. Next, we have my friend will explain the next slide.
Okay, good morning again. So now we are familiar with all the kind of reports. Now you may ask a question, although IIT Bombay X is providing some kind of reports, what makes the difference? So here are some points which we can answer. The first one is faculty role. So here, coming to the first point, allowing users to take frequently used actions from the tool. As you seen in the discussion forum activity, he can answer any question from here by redirecting to the IIT Bombay X. So what happens is when he wants to answer it in IIT Bombay X, what happens when a faculty logged in, he will see all the courses. On clicking on that course, it will go to that particular course, like courseware, discussion, everything will come. On clicking on the discussion, then he have to select unanswered, then he have to answer. What we are doing is we are providing first, as a graph, all answered, unanswered. From that, he can go directly to answer the question. So it makes the work of faculty easier. So that can also improve the course. Next one is consolidated view of student details. Means a faculty can see all the details of a particular course at one panel. So that makes the difference. And summary of discussion forum activities. And this point I have already mentioned, they like response to the student query quickly. And next one, filtering and searching. So in MOOC, number of students may be more. So in that cases, we are providing like pagination and searchings. That is the difference. Next.
Is that there a single dashboard for student data even in IIT Bombay, even in OpenEDX?
No. Sir, actually, there is no particular dashboard kind of thing in IIT Bombay. The thing is that he will open this, when he opens his account, first, he will see what are the courses. So on clicking on each course, he will get thing called as dashboard. Under that, he will get the details of that particular course only. Means for details will be of that particular course only. So we are providing like all the things at one place so that he can gather all the information of all the courses at one place.
While this is good work, but please understand that in practice, it is not extraordinarily valuable. In general, there is very rare situation that the same teacher is teaching simultaneously multiple MOOCs. It just does not happen.
Means one may not teach multiple courses at a time.
No, not may not. Can you, imagine you are a teacher. Teaching one MOOCs course is more than enough work for the whole semester.
If one teacher will teach one course only, then it will be just like that edX, open edX type.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
So what you are saying is that if a teacher is teaching multiple courses,
then it will become more useful.
Yeah.
So it will be useful in such cases where there is never a single teacher, it's a team of teachers and TA. But if there are common teachers in the team who are teaching different courses also, that means I am a team member of his course and I'm also a team member of Aparna's course, then as a teacher, when I log in, I would see both the courses, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so that would be advantage.
And one more thing is that like grade comparison is there, right? So grade comparison we have seen in the faculty panel. That we are giving like maximum average, and that is not there. Yeah, coming to the student, that is also like his enrollment reports, attendance, these kinds of things are not there in OpenADX. Next, that graphical display with maximum and in OpenADX, currently there is no relation between comparison of one student data with another student. So that thing is here for student. Next one is admin. You may ask one question like, why admin need these kind of reports? The thing is that in order to monitor the performance of admin is very interested in monitoring the performance of the application or side. So here, how he measures the performance means he can use some tools to measure the performance. But the thing is that when you use some tool to measure the performance, it will give. So it will give you. It gives you only regarding that system means if there are multiple servers running on a particular system, it will give you all the data. And coming to these kinds of reports like enrollments and these things won't be captured by any of these softwares. And one more thing which we didn't implement is the bandwidth usage of particular IIT Bombay server. That thing is not implemented, so that we have included in the future. So that may be useful for admin. Okay, next one is program manager. As you have seen, program manager role we have defined newly. So this program manager, like currently in IIT Bombay X, only IIT Bombay X is offering the courses. So in future, there may be a chance like more institute offers the course on IIT Bombay X platform. So anyone who is like a person who belongs to IIT Bombay X, he may want to see which institute course are being popular. For those kinds of reports, we have defined that role. That is not there in OpenADX.
Very much there, but they have not exposed that because the EDX, actually not Open EDX, but EDX has program manager. So they have a program manager for India, they have a program manager for Europe, they have a program manager for groups of chartered institutions, etc. So those are the people who interact with a corresponding program manager at each institution in terms of the number of courses. But that is a feature of EDX, and that feature is not available and accessible in OpenEDX. That is.
And the next one is general user. If you see the general information reports, what we have seen is like demographic representation, age-wise, and by their education level. So these things are already there in OpenEDX. But the thing is that when a faculty logs in a course, then only he will be able to see these kind of like age-wise. These reports, age-wise reports or state-wise reports, he can see after logging into a particular course. But as MOOCs are new to India, people are more interested in like how effective are the MOOCs are. So what we are giving is, we are providing that information is open. Here we are not giving any details, means like we won't give any detail of any student or any detail of any faculty. He will see only the abstract view, like how many are participating, like percentage-wise. So that is the general information reports, which is open to all.
Slight variation. I'll have to leave now for that 11 o'clock event. But I just wanted to take this opportunity to advise you on the strong privacy acts, which are the law of the land in many countries. India still does not have privacy acts yet. So the law of privacy is being contemplated. But we as an academic institution would like to be very careful about maintaining the privacy of individuals who attend our courses. And that is why we have taken the clues from what the EDX, Coursera, and everybody does. Now, how the privacy can be compromised? So I'll give you an example. What he's saying is correct, that no detailed information about the student is available at all. In fact, the privacy is maintained to such a level that most sites do not seek any information other than your name, your email ID, and your publicly postured username, which could be abracadabra, as I said. Okay. In India, we are collecting at least the PIN code. In our blended MOOCs offering, we'll necessarily collect the roll number of the student, name of the institute, etc. But this becomes private information. Now, how private information can be judged even from statistical reports. Suppose I am a resident of Manipur and I know a person who is attending a MOOCs. Now, if your statistical report shows that state-wise report, there is only one student from Manipur, then I know exactly who that student is. And later, when I see other distributed reports, I will be able to infer something about that student. I mean, so many, those of you who have done a course in databases would know how, even if I don't have permission to see something, I can write SQL queries around things to get that information. So one has to take the statistics also with a pinch of salt. And the correct implementation would be that in any case, if in any statistic, if there is an outlier, that is there is only one or two people, then that statistic should not be displayed. So that is the respect that we all need to give for the privacy of information. Damn good work. I'm very so, but all the code, etc., is properly preserved. Of course, Aparna is there, so you would have all of that, right?
Actually, whatever you are saying, like that faculty admin student, they all had been coded properly, and from that we have
made. I see. That's all. Yeah. So no private information is leaked anywhere.
No.
And all code is well documented.
Yeah.
Or only inline documentation.
No, it is well.
Very good. I'm impressed. Let's give them a big hand, but listen to their conclusions. I need to go for that event now.
Yeah, next one is achievements and challenges in learning. That will be explained by
Good morning, everyone. Myself, Amanpreet. I'm here to tell you what have we actually achieved by our project IIT Bombay XMAP. This is a monitoring application. It provides different kind of reports to different kind of users. The users here are students, faculty, admin, program manager, and the general users. Now the APIs are 40 plus that we have included here, and the two of them were delivered to blended MOOCs team. But the fact to be discussed here is that our application is actionable, which means that faculty can respond to the reports that they see on an application, like Nitish said in faculty panel that you can answer the unanswered questions, you can navigate directly to IIT Bombay site, and then you come back to the reports on map. And finally, we have been able to provide a complete implementation of our system. The system has been optimized after testing with actual data. This actual data here is the dump file that we extracted from IIT Bombay X, and reports visualization at a single place, which means that we are giving a single window view to all the reports for all the different kind of users. And this is a small effort towards advanced personalized instructions. Now, what challenges and learnings we came through while working on this project? Firstly, we have the grading policies in their calculations. Now, the fact is that all the grading policies, they are stored in MongoDB. And it's a little difficult to acquire data from MongoDB and then to display it in terms of queries. And it's also difficult to optimize that. So that was a challenge for us. Nextly, we have object relational mapping. IIT Bombay, it works on ORM calls. We worked on ORM calls. We tried to figure it out how models are used in IIT Bombay X. But by the time, we were in the middle of our project. So in our application, we have fired SQL queries and not ORM calls. But this can be a future recommendation. Next, we have used high charts to represent the graphical reports. We have adapted technologies like Bootstrap, jQuery, Ajax, Django, MongoDB, and MySQL. We have worked on both MySQL and MongoDB, reflecting the differences between the two databases. Finally, we have documented our entire project, and we've learned the importance of version control here. And we came, we've optimized our queries all throughout this project. When we worked on actual data, we found that some of our codes or some of our APIs, they were lagging behind in terms of the time they were taking place to process. And finally, we have integrated this entire thing within time and tested this with actual data so that we can provide you with an effective deliverable. Now, don't get faced by seemingly impossible barriers. Now, I would explain to you one of the barriers which came through when we were working through this project. We worked on grading policies. Grading policies earlier was taking around 45 minutes just to process. So the student and faculty panel, they were taking a lot more time than needed. We optimized that query. We have been able to reduce the time to around 4 minutes. So that was a complete team effort here. Nextly, collaboration and coordination was needed to the entire project, and we were able to achieve that. We have been accommodative and patient throughout this entire project. Different people, they have worked on this, and different people have been helpful enough to share their knowledge with each other and contribute in their own areas of strength. The future roadmap will be discussed by the...
Okay, as we figured out some of the drawbacks, first one is when you redirect to IDOMX for answering a question, it's asking again for credentials. So that is a drawback currently we are having. We try to implement that, it's not possible. So that is one of the future recommendations. And bandwidth utilization, as we said, it should be in admin reports. We didn't implement that, so it is also one of the future recommendations. And code optimization, although we have optimized the grading code from 45 minutes to 4 minutes, 4 minutes is also a big time to run a particular report. So that need to be optimized more. And online surveys reports, actually currently in OpenADX, there is no any survey block. Like a faculty cannot conduct his own survey. So we wanted to provide a survey platform that is not implemented. And ORM calls, as we have discussed, we figured out the way, but it is very late. So we have implemented everything using queries. So it is, as everything in IDOMX is in ORM calls, it is recommended to implement the thing in ORM call also. And next one, same user. If you see, admin, faculty, student roles are there. A faculty can also take a course in MOOC, but such kind of provision is not there here. So that thing need to be implemented. And reports for staff role. Along with instructor, there may be staff for a course. For staff also, we need to provide the reports. Conclusion. Coming to the conclusion, we have explained everything about IDOMX map. Instead of reading that conclusion, I can say that if the future recommendations are implemented, the project may be useful for effective learning of the student behavior. So these are our team members. Once again, I want to thank all the people for patiently listening. And I would like to thank again Phatak sir and Avati sir and Aparna ma'am for getting us this project and spending them with us. Thank you.